Now, for some reason, I've always wanted to build something that could go to the bottom of Lake Tahoe. And while I didn't really have any extra time this summer, I decided that I just kind of had to do it. Now, Lake Tahoe is about 1,600 feet deep, and if you just drop a GoPro down, it would just explode. Now, I'm not exactly the first person to send something down to Lake Tahoe. There's this other guy on YouTube who's put a GoPro in a little box and sent that thing down a couple times. There's a lot of myths going around about all this crazy stuff that could be at the bottom, like a bunch of dead bodies, dead planes, like old mob bosses and stuff. Probably not gonna see any of that stuff, even if it was down there. There's honestly, like, no way. If you just drop a camera straight down, you're only gonna see, like, you know, a couple feet around that thing, and that's pretty much it.
So just to illustrate, if Lake Tahoe was the size of this bathtub, it would be about 0.6 inches deep, and a person would fit on the end of this hair, and the view from a camera would only ever be about the diameter of this hair. Now, a boat would be about 10 thou long, if it was 30 feet long, like that gap right there in these calipers, and if you move this at 3 miles an hour, it would take 100 years to go through the whole thing. And there's 360 million different places that this can fit. Like, I mean, you can divide that by 100,000 if you think there's 100,000 bodies down there.
If you actually want to see anything, you need to go out there, do a bunch of sonar soundings, actually, like, see what's down there, and then go explore those structures with your sweet new camera.
So this is what I got. I made that 2 pieces. The only thing it really does is make this part longer, so I can't get cameras quite as close. It's so much easier to make.
It's kind of sweet.
So I sized the housing to hold these sort of cameras. Nice big live stream cameras that are definitely future proof. And then to size all the window dimensions, I made this sweet little Excel sheet where I can plug in a window diameter, seal angle, yield strength of the material, blah, 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 blah. So now it's 0.47 thick. And we got a 2.25 inch hole in the middle to look through. Let's see, we got around 6,000 feet with that same size window. Now we'll need a 0.59 inch or like a little happy safety factor on it. It's not like compromised distress or anything like that. It's just so. And some analysis. It's like, it's really not moving. You don't have to worry about it at all, which is what I figured, but I just wanted to run one of these.
So now let's get some drawings made and start building this thing.
Got this on the lathe, the 3-inch piece of stock. It's small enough that I'm just gonna turn it into chips. This is the last. She's bored out to 3 inches and took out the cross feed and did this 20 degree cut for the seal for the window. Now I'm taking this down by about 2 inches, down to a little less than 4. And I just cut the O-rings in her. So she's looking pretty nice. Now I'm drilling some pilot holes. I'm gonna drill these out a little bit bigger to clear 5/16 bolts. 6 of them. And then mercury. Thank you. Yeah, that's pretty much that. And there she is. Just threw some chamfers on the holes. Oh yeah, it's nothing like the feeling when you get a tap and it goes through. There is nothing quite like tapping a few threads. So these are 1/4 by 20. That is the size for pipe tap, 1/2 inch pipe. Well, that'll do it. 2 1/2 inch NPTs, nice sharp tap. Unfortunately, I actually lost a piece of footage where I make the windows. Basically, I just started with a trunk of acrylic that was 3 inches thick. It was just like this sort of finish, and I just machined it down, and you couldn't see anything through it at all. It was completely frosty. Basically, just took it over to a flat surface. I actually used a sandwich table, you know, threw sandpaper down on the flat surface, and then just sat there and polished it from 300 grit, you know, 1,000, 2,000, 4,000, 6,000, 8,000, and actually up to 12,000 grit sandpaper. And then by the end of that, it was like looking super clear. For the little lights, I was able to buy 1/2 inch thick acrylic. I just cut the little bevels, that little 20 degree angle, and just pulled the paper off and just had a clear window. So I also drilled out this bad boy. Yeah, not gonna do much at all with this. Yeah, the original plan was actually to use a solid rod with the window groove in here. The lathe chucks was just not big enough. and it was just way too sketchy to be boring this thing out. So I decided to scrap it and go with a big thick wall tube. Literally just like Scotch-Brite, some sandpaper, just like a little bit. That's pretty good. The inside finish is actually pretty nice. I think it'll work absolutely fine. It's just, you know, totally out of round. Things cut just on a bandsaw. You know, just cut it on a bandsaw, grind it on the disc sander. It just needs to be the right shape. This is pretty much it. The right amount of holes in it. This is the main bracket. So this bolts onto the center housing, lights bolt onto it, and then the tail fin thing bolts onto the top here. Gotta be honest, this gets me a little bit excited. So just drilling these out now. Got a nice little counter bore in there. I have a quick change chuck in here, so I'm just switching these out. Lickety split and drilling the countersink. Just doing a little light milling, getting her flat. This is what that top bar clamps to, so it doesn't matter if it's flat. And there is the finished part. I would say it doesn't look too bad. Got her held and just hitting her with a punch. And that is how I'm drilling the holes. Just match drilling. It's easy as hell. Just use a fucking drill and fucking put a thing on it so you don't go too deep. And then just send it. It's fast. Oh hell yeah. It's pure sexiness right here. Oh yeah. Got front cap. Window goes here. This thing slips into there. Two O-rings. The rear cap, single O-ring. Got the ports coming in the mail. That shoots on like that. This is the front window. So this goes on there. And then on the front, so it's like a three-piece front window. Four-piece if you include this window piece, which is pretty clear. A polished chunk of acrylic with the perfect groove. Sitting right like that. And then these are lights. Go up on the top. These little things go on there. And then I do have the glass that goes in there too. Little O-ring seal. And then this has a single O-ring groove there. Bolts kind of go everywhere. There's actually another little piece that I haven't made yet that'll go on the back and probably be a tail. It's not totally necessary, but I think I'm gonna end up using it. Drilling holes. Hell yeah, got some pilot holes in. I'm just drilling holes with a drill. 3/8 of an inch on the end, so I can hook a drill up to it if I ever need to. And just got that cut done. So this is the shaft. So the crank goes on here. There's some keyways on here with that rubber thing over it. Oh. Wow. Big fan of the server press. So I redid this shit with some of that Permatex steel weld. Just to hold the keyways on so they won't move around as much. So, because of the interesting way that I live my life, I'm out here with the Miata. And, yeah, this is where I'm gonna chromate conversion and paint the fucking camera. Yeah, I just come over here. Not joking, I'm like literally fucking, it looks like I'm cooking meth back here. This 150 grit sandpaper here. Sand everything down. Give it a good rinsing with the acetone. I got this tray, which is full of Aluma Prep. Actual Aladdin over here, which I just kind of like paint on like that. And I just Aladdined all the parts. It's pretty poor Aladdin job. Things are looking a little green, but not super green. So I'm gonna do a little painting on these parts. Up here in the mountains. Looking pretty sick. Yeah. Just bored out these guys to this size so they can fit this thing. That looks pretty good to me. A little squeaky. Just got this thing in the arbor press.
buttons on it.
It's like, use this handle and not that one.
And it's enough. It was enough.
Yep, there. It was enough.
Yeah, crane thing. Got it right there. Got all this stuff over here. And
I'm in an apartment, as you can tell.
That is mostly the crane. It's pretty great.
A lot of magic involved in this. So crazy.
I just hit each one individually in with this thing. I don't know, it worked fine.
Basically, I don't want to lose preload and start like cycle fatiguing and start like wearing stuff out, so I just threw a little bit of Permatex steel weld on there, tightening up all the bolts. Ring on there, and on goes this beautiful piece of acrylic. On goes this. Sweet. And lots of bolts that are going in here. Oh yeah, got some lights. Pushes in the window a little. I already got the silicone in there. Ho 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 ho. Ho ho ho. Yeah. So, got one light on. And basically, all I'm doing is throwing a threaded rod in there. Ho ho ho. This is pretty heroic. I got these side vent ports. Basically, like I'm going up and down in altitude. I don't want this thing like popping out. So I got these like cool O-rings that are in washers. And the weak port for the main chamber is pretty similar, but it's a half inch bolt this time. Got this piece going. They're threaded from this side.
Got this curing PTFE sealant. Good to like 10,000 PSI fluid. Oh yeah. Look at that, $26.
So the original plan was actually to have live feed cameras. I bought a couple, I was experimenting with them a little bit. These are just like regular coaxial security cameras. The tether was gonna get way too complicated for the amount of time that I had. So I just decided to use a GoPro. It would just be good enough for the first test. I'm probably gonna add something similar to this later.
So I am currently in my car at a laundromat and I am doing some electrical wirings.
I'm going to put these in some vinyl coating, and we should be a lot more set. The electrical wiring on this was actually pretty simple. I just have 2 6-volt batteries in there, and I wired them up in series for 12 volts. And I have these little fuse boxes with these 2-amp fuses in them. That's just in case one of these lights leaks and starts a short circuit. Basically, series those up. They come out, they go through that, they come out here, go over to their respective lights, wrap them in electrical tape and heat shrink, and then put them in a tube. And basically these will just fill with water, but I'm not super worried about that because the connection on the inside should be good. And there's like a long enough conductive path here and it's not salty water, so it shouldn't conduct the other ones. Definitely wouldn't work if I was trying to transfer any data or anything like that. Super simple on this one. It's not very elegant, but it should work. And then all these feed-throughs are actually from a company called Pave Technology. You can actually just buy feed-throughs and they're good enough to high pressures. This is all the tail fin is, just a chunk of aluminum with a couple holes in it. And then this is the thing that holds it up. Just threaded a little rod in the end.
That just threads in the back of this. This is stainless steel.
This is the only chunk of stainless steel on this. All the rest is aluminum.
Oh, I'm on the way! I'm on the way up to Lake Tahoe right now. I'm pretty scared. I don't want some Indian chief curse. I don't know, it's just gonna be fun. We're gonna see what happens.
There's Lake Tahoe.
Probably not gonna see too much of anything because I don't have any landing gear on it. I also have no live feed yet, so I'm not actually gonna be able to look for stuff. I also have no motor, so I'm not gonna be able to drive around and actually look at things that are cool. Hopefully the crane will work. I definitely didn't build any floaties for it, so it's gonna be heavy as shit. Hopefully I won't get it stuck on a rock and then lose the thing forever.
A little bit snowy in the mountains. Pretty cool. Just bought a bunch of random plumbing shit.
docks are empty. Not too surprising, it's pretty late season.
So yeah, I think one of those boats tomorrow. It's gonna be pretty expensive though. Oh well. I just have to cut these boards really quick. So I parked in this parking area. I got my rock. I got this little saw. Gotta make a little protector for the boat tomorrow. Gotta be honest, not having a workshop kinda sucks.
I'm in the woods.
Doing shit. Run two screws in it. Cause this is just a fit up. I don't have enough space in this Miata. Now I am pretty excited about this. Made this Plumbing Park's cable reel holder.
Super pretty. Got a little waterfall here.
Yes, I'm on a boat on Lake Tahoe!
So basically, just gonna pack shit up, drop it in the water, and see how she do. I have no trolling motor or anything, so it's gonna be pretty hard. I could be stranded in the middle of this lake soon.
And we are recording, so you're going in here, and you're gonna stay recording the whole time.
Got lights.
Alright, so I'm ready to lower it in. I don't know what happened to my GoPro, they might have stolen it. But anyway, it doesn't matter. Found the GoPro. It was hiding under the seat, so now I can film shit. We'll be right back.
not think I'd make it. Barely made it. But I got it. Fucking crazy. I did not hit the bottom. I'll have to measure how deep I got. No leaks, that deep, I guess.
Got it back.
All that cable.
No leaks.
At all.
Gotta figure out how to get this in my freaking Miata.
There is a mystical craft.
Yeah, those things lost preload.
Yeah, I'll check all the nuts and see what's good, but these all filled with water. Didn't matter at all.
Yeah, so I'm pretty stoked about this. I don't know how far it went down. Haven't measured the cable yet. I think it was probably 1,000 feet, something like that. But yeah, it worked. No leaks at all.
Just want to show you how full my car is. Here's the cable. It all fit.
Gotta try and figure out how to measure this shit. My best inaccurate measurement down it.
Why do I hate myself so much? Oh my god. It's an unbelievably tangled mess. Oh my god. I got pretty far, but now things have gone to shit. This has already been like an hour and a half.
So bad.
Yeah, it's been like 2.5 hours. Thinking about cutting it. I don't think I'm gonna cut it though.
Well, I did it systematically for most of that time. I've recently resorted back to the shake and pray. It's getting lighter and closer. Oh my god. I see the light. The end of the cable. Totally not tangled. Oh, however long it is, I'm gonna measure now.
So you are on this stick. It goes over a lot of bumps and stuff. It's gonna be kind of approximate.
I measured it, it was 1262 or whatever, and then I measured again, it was 1262. When I started dragging it in, there was like probably 20 feet of slack. There's another 20 feet that I cut off, and like I'd wrapped it around the crane and I just like cut it when we pulled it out of the boat. Also, I did a calculation on rope stretch for 1/8-inch cable, 7x7 galvanized steel. I calculated it for 1200 feet. Should be like 38 feet of cable stretch there with a 40-pound mass on the end. I mean, that puts me over 1300 feet, so I'm just gonna say that it was 1300 feet. Not really, I mean, it was at a slight angle, so it's probably like a bit less than that, because we're getting pulled by the boat at like a very slow speed, out between 12 and 1300 feet. But I'm just gonna say 1300 feet. That doesn't matter. What matters is it went that like that deep and it didn't leak. Obviously I need to make a better capstan. I mean, it only took like 2 hours. It wasn't that bad. If I was out there and didn't have a time constraint and wasn't paying $200 an hour and it wasn't like a storm coming in, I mean, I would have just sat there and cranked it in. That's what I was planning on doing. But the situation kind of led it to like, all right, you gotta get the shit out of the water by 2, otherwise this place is gonna close and they're gonna make you cut it. Also, there's a storm coming in, which is probably gonna hit at like 1. And also, like, if the storm is going crazy, you might drop the cable, and then a fucking loop comes up, catches your foot, and then you're dead. Like, I knew that I wasn't gonna see anything this time. I knew it was just gonna be a drop and go. If I hit the bottom, that would've been awesome. Even if I did make it to the bottom, it's not gonna see anything. But I definitely need like some sort of side scan sonar if I'm gonna try and like find any actual buried treasure. The only thing I could see with this is like if there's a Blakeness monster in it. All right, thanks for watching. Bye.